See, this is where people fuck up when they cheat. They cheat, they lie, they deny, they get caught, and then they still lie, or they're forced to come clean, and then you know what happens? They try to work it out, but because you've been lying when I gave you the opportunity to be honest, it will never work out.
I agree with you.
But if you keep that shit 100, when push comes to shove and your back is against the wall, and you just be honest about the shit, they might leave you. Yes, it's a big reality. But guess what? If that person stays with you after you told them that you cheated on them, that person is really fucking rocking with you. Because for me to stay with you and I know you cheated on me, I got to really care about you on a different type of level.
Okay. To be honest, I feel like the only way a relationship can move forward, no hanging over the head, we really, really solidly going to try to work this out is if there was no evidence. You came to me because you felt guilty in your head and said, this is what I did. I cheated. Can you forgive me and can we move forward? If you had to wait until someone else found evidence in the first place to confess to cheating, how are we moving on from that?
Listen, when you
Because if I didn't have evidence, you were never going to tell me and we were going to continue this relationship with you doing what you did and I can't fully trust
you. But here's the thing. You lose all power. You cheated. And like Rico said, we're all saying, if you're trying to move forward, you got to just take that on the chin. You can't look there and say that, oh my God, if you don't have evidence, if you did have evidence, look, you lose that. And if you don't want to lose that, then leave. Leave the relationship. Don't do it. But you can't sit there and like give them the ultimatum. Like he's like, yo, like I have proof. Or he's hinting at it. At least put the man out of his misery. If you care that much, you at least give him that much grace to at least let him process it. But you holding in line to their face, you will never, ever, ever get that friendship back, get that person back. That's what we're saying. And that's fucked up.
But do you understand that, Oliver, like once you understand a woman, you're going to understand everything. Women cheat with emotion.
No, women you can't say all women.
Most women, I never cheated and I did not have some type of emotion to the other dude. Most women go into cheat with emotion. And I know for a fact there's men that could go outside in a corner, do what they do, never speak to homegirl again, and they are fine. So when a man looking at a woman, like, oh, damn, you cheat on me, he's not just thinking you. He knows an emotion. He knows you attached to this other dude. So it's a lot for a woman. It's more on the line for me by admitting to cheating than you admit to cheating. Women are very forgiving. Oh, I'm going to forgive you. But men, they will forgive you and make you go through hell.
That's what I said. You lose that power. Once you lose that power, you can't worry about that. You can't worry about who's more forgiving or not. You lose that right. You lose that right to worry about that.
But that's what I'm saying. At the end of the day, I already messed up. I already cheated. You know what I'm saying? And I already cheated and I already hurt you. I already been disrespectful. If worse comes to worse, when I go into cheating, I know the consequences. So,
yeah, but you know. Honestly,
I can't do
that. I cheated on a girl because she kept accusing me for cheating.
What?
No, that doesn't make any sense.
I'm glad you said that. That's such an old school line.
She kept accusing me for cheating. And
you're supposed to make her feel secure.
No, I did.
Or if you feel like that's too much, then you don't
listen,
need to be with
her.
I agree.
The thing is, and this goes back to what I said before. Every time I got into another platform in my life, the girl that I was with got insecure because the attention and everything grew. So when I got out of high school, we were dating for 2 years, and now I'm playing college football, and I'm starting as a freshman, and I got all the entire school behind me. She thought I was cheating on her, and I really wasn't. So then the fights never stopped. The arguments never stopped. So you know what I did? I said, you know what? I'm going to make you right. You want me to be a cheater so bad, I'll be a cheater for you.
You've been wanting to
and
cheat.
So, no, I didn't want to cheat. No funny shit. I did not want
to
cheat. I did not want to cheat. So what ended up happening was, she's like, fine, if you're going to go cheat, then bye. It's over. So
you might be younger.
All
20,
you had
right?
to do was leave that girl.
But he was younger too.
Yo, but listen, the moral of the story.
Anybody? That's my thing.
No, I was not entertaining nobody. I was taking 18 college credits as a biology major playing college football. And if anybody that knows that playing college football is average over 45 hours a week that you're dedicated to a sport, not including school. I didn't even have time to sleep. I was sleeping 4 hours a night. I don't give a fuck about pussy right now. I'm trying to go to the league. And you're over here bickering and bitching because bitches, Instagram just started and bitches are trying to say, hey, I can't wait to see you at your game. They're all watching me. There's 30,000 people in
okay,
there.
Okay, well, that's insecure. So
now when I said, I'm going to make you right, she said, I'm leaving. So she left. I went and I fucked 4 bitches. And then she tried to come back. She said, did you go fuck a bitch? I said, I went and fucked 4 bitches. Do you want to stay or do you want to go?
Cheating, though?
She left.
But like, here's the thing. I knew she was going to be.
No, he said that she left.
But I knew she was going to be back. So like, to me, if you break up with me and I know we're going to get back together, that's still cheating.
It was a pity breakup. It was exactly. Like, I'm leaving, but I'll talk to you.
But I'm still not leaving. Yeah.
It wasn't cheating.
So yeah. I still count it as cheating because, you feel me, at the end of the day.
It was not official. There's no,
and I know you're going to be back. And I know I'm going to take you back. You feel me? I did that before. But after I did that.
Sounds like a white lie.
After I did that, you know, we got back together. And then I realized what other pussy was like. So I was like, now you got to go because now I want new pussy. So it's over. Being back to what we're trying to say is that, like, this is what I think. And Crystal, you could piggyback off of it. Danny, right? When you're lying about something that is already kind of like factual, that is a level of disrespect that is unforgiving for most, if not all men, and probably women, but I can't speak for women, because the disrespect that you can look me dead in my eyes and still lie to me knowing that I know, that's something I can't ever get over, because now I could never trust you on your word. Your actions could be fucked up from time to time, but I can't trust you on your word, which is worse.
And it shows us your character as a person. And then it makes me question everything else. Was this relationship ever real?
Yeah, because we don't see all actions. Like, but if you got to trust people on their word, especially if that's your spouse, that's your partner, yeah. Because I can't be walking behind you, finding evidence 24/7. Exactly. So I got to believe what you're telling me.
Okay, I get it. It's something I'm working on. It's just like we all different, but I just feel like even by cheating is already being disrespectful. And I just feel like when I cheat, it's for different reason. And it's kind of like, just because I cheated, not because I don't love you. If I love you, I can't hurt you. I can't watch you being hurt.
Do you agree that cheating is a selfish act? Yes or no?
I mean, I would say cheating is selfish.
All right, so how do you bring love into that? Because you said, I love you, I'm gonna lie to you, but you're doing something selfish.
Come on, man. Like, we done with this conversation.
Okay,
like,
now we're wrapping it up. Now
we're I respect where you're coming from because you being real. You know what I'm saying? Like,
really?
She's being real. No, what I'm saying is she's being real. Like, she's not gonna go tell that person tell him that she's cheating. Because she doesn't want to be selfish. She don't want to be selfish to that person, because at the end of the day, if you're still trying to stay with him or still continue with him,
that's selfish.
It's selfish, but I feel like it's more selfish to break that person down and then continue to try to go in their life. That's just me. Like, so I feel like if you're going to try to continue to go in that person's life, the way where you're coming from, you just being real, like you don't want to hurt them. You know, you're going to try to come back. You know, you're going to continue to express your emotions. So you got to, you know, you just got to, I guess, cheat respectfully. But
I'll tell you this. I had so much hope for you.
I know.
I had so much hope.
Listen, I'm just going off of her perspective. For me in general, like, just talking off of me, like, I respect where she's coming from, because you guys never heard that, like, telling someone you cheated is more selfish than, like...
No, I've never heard
honestly,
that.
Honestly, I've talked to people and they say telling someone that
stop
you cheated...
Stop talking to those people.
Yes.
Don't talk to them no more.
All right, whatever. Just to go off of me. I feel like cheating, like, for me, it just depends. Like, are we locked in? Did we say, like, yo, we're dating, you're my person? Or are we just, like...
The way y'all are moving this goalpost is ridiculous, but okay.
I feel like cheating is... Cheating when you actually have committed, like, listen, we are these people together, and that's what it is. But if you're just walking through life and you're just, like, tugging a person around, you're not really telling them, like, oh, like, listen, you my woman, when we walk in a room, this is what it is. Like, or when we go anywhere.
If I'm your man, are you cheating on me?
Did you tell me you're my man?
Well, Oliver.
We agree.
Yes, we are in a relationship.
That's what I'm saying.
We're not talking about the guy that we're not talking about Bob that you're stringing on our dates.
No, I'm not saying that. Okay, so you're saying
right now, you are my girlfriend, I'm your boyfriend.
Okay.
What else do you need?
What I was trying to get out is a lot of, like, right now in 2021, there's a lot of people that are just dating. Like, they're dating openly and that's they're not committing.
About. That's not what we're talking about. We gave 6,000 scenarios. Proof of cell phone. You was like, well, is it Verizon or is it T-Mobile?
Okay, all right. So,
giving
All right, the clear scenario.
Is it blue bubble or green bubble? Listen, doesn't matter. It's proof is in the pudding.
I'm just
saying. No, because if it's a green bubble, fake text. That was not me.
You know what?
It wasn't me.
I give up. Rico, you can go ahead.
I'll be honest with you. Like, I'll be honest with you.
Women are toxic.
If a girl cheated on me.
I'm just saying, if you're not telling me, if we're not distinguishing this, and I guess we already distinguished it, but I'm just like opening it up because it can be very complicated.
Okay, I give you that.
Yo, I watched a show yesterday or 2 days ago called Clickbait, right? Mm-hmm. I don't know if you guys saw it.
No, I heard about everybody talking about it.
All right,
it.
So I'm not going to spoil it.
No,
but,
you can go ahead.
But in the beginning, the woman who's a professor cheats on her husband, right? And she cheats on her husband with another coworker, teacher, a colleague, right? So she actually just comes clean to him.
Fire.
And then, you know, they have problems in a relationship, but he stays. They actually, like, he was broken for a minute, but then, you know, it shows that they're trying to gradually work through something. Because the level of respect that I have for somebody who comes up to me, and I'm not saying that I could 100% take a woman back immediately when she cheats on me, but I guarantee you this, there is a possible second chance for that girl.
Versus the lie.
Possible. If you lie to me in my face and I know you're fucking lying, you have zero chance of ever coming back into my life. I would never look out for you. I would never help you. I would never speak to you or be around you or want to. Now, if you come to me and say, yo, look, you know, 6 months ago, this has been weighing in on me and such happened, and you just come clean, or if I ask you and you come clean, I'm going to respect you more. I might be hurt at that moment. Don't get me wrong, but I respect you more going forward. And I don't know how long that looks like, but you have a possible second chance.